So when we last talked about this, we just, it was at the beginning. We're like, there's rumors, and now it was confirmed that these teams are in a separate European Super League. And that was like weeks ago. That was like day two of the news coming out. So then little by little, the fans, the sports analysts, and like players themselves on the teams that are in the Super League will like just say like, this isn't right. This is solely for money and not the, for the heart of football. And like, we're disrespectful to our fans and I hope this doesn't happen. And fans would protest like crazy outside of stadiums. Like, it was crazy. Like, fans protested a Chelsea game and they didn't let the bus go into the stadium.
Oh my God.
Yeah. And they had
to get an ex-player,
like a club legend, to go out and be like, hey, like, we understand you're upset and stuff like this, but this isn't the way to do it. Let the players in and just keep voicing your concerns, but you can't let the players not do what they have to do. Little by little, clubs were starting to say, like, you know, maybe we're going to go back on this and stuff like that.
Yeah, there are rumors of, like, caving
in the background.
And this all happened over, like, 4 days, right?
Like 2 days.
It was so fast. And then that same game where the Chelsea players couldn't get in, like, Chelsea, like, the club said, like, we're going to back away from the European Super League and we feel like it's a mistake of what we did. And then Manchester City had, like, official statement, we're backing away. It was a mistake and we're going to re-see what we do in the future. And then Arsenal and Tottenham did it, and Liverpool, and then eventually all the Premier League
teams got a domino effect of all the English teams.
So all the English teams were out. The Italian teams didn't really say anything official, but they kind of hinted that they're not going to do this anymore. And Atletico Madrid hinted that they're not going to do it anymore. And Barca hinted that they're not going to do it anymore. But Juventus didn't really say anything because the Juventus, like, vice president is like the vice president of the European Super League. And Real Madrid didn't say anything because the president of Real Madrid is the president of the European Super League. So then
they were probably just waiting for it to just, they knew that the writing was on the wall and they were just like, let's just save face and just go down with the ship, but then just act like nothing happened. Nah. Really?
Then
no.
Order 66. So then everyone's saying, like, all right, all these teams are pulling out. The president has to say something. Like, he has to go say something. Like, they're wanting to know what's he gonna say. Like, they're expecting him to say, like, hey, like, as every other team is saying, this was a mistake, and now we have no teams confirmed and committed.
Or at least give us an insight, like, what the hell is going on?
Like, we fucked up. But then instead, he goes on, like, the media, and he says, like, the Super League's still gonna happen.
Oh, shit.
Like, we're not dead. Like,
we're not dead. Like, we're gonna find out how to fill up the teams and stuff like that. And then eventually he starts saying, the teams that said they pulled out have a contract in the Super League.
Ooh. It's a 10-year contract.
Yeah. No.
And they paid like $20 million to get in. And there's a penalty if they break the contract.
So he got pissed. Like, he wasn't going to, you know.
Gotcha.
Okay.
They already signed the contracts?
I guess so.
This apparently this guy is all pre-done.
There's contracts and shit. And he said it's still happening. He doesn't care. It's still happening.
Yeah, he basically says, like, it's a necessity. Like, the way
we need to.
The way soccer is now, he says it's not going to last past 2024.
He said a bunch of crazy shit,
too. He said 2024, soccer will be dead. He says, like, kids they don't like watching soccer anymore. Like, the 16 to 24-year-old demographic, they don't care about soccer. Like, they're more worried about other shit.
Too busy playing Warzone.
Yeah, too busy playing Warzone,
wait,
I guess.
But is that legit?
That's not legit. There's no way that's legit.
Yeah,
no,
I don't believe it either. I don't believe it for a second.
Yeah, I think soccer's booming the most ever, especially in, like, the United States. But he's like, you know, sometimes the games are too long. Maybe we're going to change the rules and shorten them or some shit like that. Yeah. Like, he wants to change rules of games and shit.
Shut up.
God, this guy.
Yeah.
Like, what was the last time there was a rule change in soccer?
There's always rule changes.
They're little tiny changes.
The biggest rule change was about a couple of years ago where they instituted video assistant replay.
VAR. Well, no, I don't mean by that. I mean, like, rules of the game.
Every sport did
like
that.
Like, the traditional rules of the game?
Yes.
Like, decades ago, I feel. Like, offsides would be the biggest one.
Might be the most controversial one.
But that's fair.
On a smaller scale.
I feel like that's a fair rule.
On a smaller scale, MLS used to have the penalties differently. Like, they would have someone start at the middle of the field, and dribble to the goal to shoot.
I see.
Instead of just kicking from the spot.
Dude, this is the same shit that baseball's trying to do by shortening the games. Like he said, they're trying to shorten the game. So like they'll take some things out. Baseball, they put the guy in second now.
What's happening now?
Extra innings, there's someone automatically placed on second.
Wow.
Yeah. There's a pitch clock. You only have a few amount of calls to the pitcher.
Why are they doing that? Honestly,
I know, it's stupid.
I'm going to be honest with you. Baseball games, like everyone's always like, oh my God, they're so long, they're so boring. I feel like they fly by.
Yeah, if you're watching, if you understand, you want it to keep going. You don't want that shit to stop.
Yeah, I feel like baseball games go very fast, way faster than like football, in my opinion. But so they were trying to change rules.
Well, he's trying to change the rules. Well, he didn't say he's going to, but he mentioned changing rules. He mentioned people don't care about soccer and it's going to die. And he mentioned, like, dude, we need this money.
Yeah, does this guy even like, he owns the team, but does he even like soccer?
This guy's trying to make money.
This guy's nuts.
Apparently he said that his team, Real Madrid, suffered $400 million in losses because of COVID. So, like, it's a necessity that they be a part of this. And he says a necessity for all these other teams to be a part of this because the way the structure is currently, they're losing money and the smaller teams are making money through like broadcasting rights and like image rights and all that shit.
Funny.
And he said, and he's pissed at the European Football Association, UEFA, because they're the ones that are making bank out of it. So that's kind of like the reasoning why these clubs want to split away, because they feel like they're not getting their fair share, even though they're bringing, you know, the viewership, the money into the competition and the leagues. But then he wanted to say crazy shit like no one cares about it.
So when was this?
That was like a day later.
Yeah, it was like
okay.
The next day.
We're still like two days in.
Keep going. Yeah.
So then at that point, the Italian team started coming that they're going to leave the league. So Inter Milan, AC Milan, Juventus dipped. And then Atletico Madrid also dipped. So the last two left were Barcelona and Real Madrid. The thing with Barcelona
is just them two facing each other.
Yeah, the two rivals. Yeah, yeah, stayed in. So Barcelona, they stayed in, saying that they need it because they're probably one of the of all the clubs that probably have the biggest financial crisis because they're like $1 billion in debt.
Oh my God,
crazy!
And their problem is like they have a lot of like short term debt they have to figure out. So they, from a financial sense, like they definitely need that shit, but from obviously a sporting sense and a fan sense, like the fans don't want it. What Barcelona did is they have this clause in the contract, since they're kind of like a democratically elected club, that they're going to leave it up to the members to decide if they want to be in it or not.
So, and they probably said no.
They haven't done the votes yet.
But they're most likely.
The way it looks like, they don't, the fans don't want that shit. So it just leaves Real Madrid. They're the only ones that, obviously, the president being the president of this fucking league, they're not going to dip out of it.
Yeah.
But then the league doesn't exist. So then,
if they have a contract.
Contracts and shit.
So now the question, because like all these clubs dipped, but this fucking guy is coming out saying like they have a binding contract that they're in it to win it for 10 years.
So they're just going to basically profit off. Is there some kind of clause?
Profit. So what's going to happen is if these teams are serious about leaving and they did sign the contract, they have to break their clause, basically. Mm-hmm. And they're going to have to pay the fee. You
know, according to...
And now whoever they're paying the fee to is making bank.
Yeah.
So that guy just got away with it. Was this
like a scheme all along from the president of Real Madrid to be like, you know what, let me steal this money from my fucking rival clubs.
Yeah.
He's literally in a win-win situation.
Dude, this is like, he's like playing like 4D chess right now. Literally. This is like fucking like 40D chess
you pull the heist of the century.
Like if I were one of the teams, can't you just be like, all right, we're still in it, but we forfeit every game in our season?
They won't be able to play, and they're paying players for nothing.
And you lose the chances of like the winnings from it.
Yeah, they wouldn't do that.
And then, like, and now those people can't play in FIFA, so they're just essentially sitting home and doing nothing. So it kind of sucks.
It's. I feel like it's just a game of chicken.
Like, I feel like, damn, dude.
To kind of sum up, because like a lot should happen, but like basically it ended up that all these teams dipped, so they put a pause on the Super League. They didn't kill it. They paused it. So what looking like is they're going to go back to the drawing board and restructure it. The issue now is the European Football Association, UEFA, they restructured their tournament, which is the current tournament that's going on, the Champions League, to expand it to more teams. But the problem is, like, the extra teams that are coming in are all the big teams from the big clubs.
Yeah.
So people are complaining. It's like, what was the point? What's the point if, like, they're kind of
making a Super League?
Making a
so now those, yeah,
Super League.
I guess they were hopping on the bandwagon. But wow. So now those teams that were initially going to be a part of the Super League can now be in the,
Yeah, so at this point, like, again? Yeah, they're still, like, they never passed any, like, sanctions or anything. They were just threats.
Gotcha.
According to some judicial committee, said that, like, you couldn't pass those sanctions to begin with, but they were looking to try to ban Real Madrid and whoever was still in the Super League from, like, international competition. But I don't think, like, at this point, I don't think anything has happened. I don't see anything, like, they're still pushing towards that. What it looks like is, like I said, the Super League is suspended, but I think they're going to reform it.